1500 metres. Lights on. All set and ready. And button pushed. Gates open and away. Recall was the last one out here for checks. Boab, Boy both left well. The filly going through on the inside. Princess in Red. She's third early on. Followed by Playing Rio getting up to fourth. Fly with Caution fifth. Then Ocean Zara. On the outside is Keep Attacking there. Followed by Fast Flicker, who's well back with Galaxy Affair. And Hemlock Stone on the outside's rushing up around them. And Recall is the last one. Inside the 1,000, it's Boab, Boy leading for Fiori. And is about two lengths in front of here for checks, getting into second. On the inside is Princess in Red and Playing Rio fourth. A length away to Fly with Caution fifth. One and a half then to Keep Attacking. Ocean Zara's on the fence, covered by Hemlock Stone, who's fourth to last. A length in front of Fast Flicker on the outside of Recalled, and Galaxy Affair is now at the end of the field. They've gone past the 600 and heading toward the home turn with Boab Boy leading a length and a half here for checks. Playing Rio, Princess in Red, the inside. Fly with Caution one off and out three wide as they come to the turn as Keep Attacking, then Ocean Zara. Well back are Fast Flicker and Hemlock Stone as they're about to wheel in, followed by Recalled and Galaxy Affair as last. Boab Boy was first to see the judge, but here for checks getting closer. Then Princess in Red over on the inside and Fly with Caution on the outside. Down towards the 100. Fly with Caution races up now to Boab Boy. Late Fast Flicker, but it's all over. Fly with Caution wins again. Fly with Caution from either Boab Boy or Fast Flicker. Photo fourth. Recalled was there with Here for Checks and Princess in Red on the inside. And out wider on the track was Keep Attacking, Hemlock Stone behind those. They were followed by Playing Rio together with Recalled, and Galaxy Affair was always rearward. Fly with Caution, Michael Poy for trainer Robert Witten. Back-to-back wins. Interim numbers 10, 3, 4 and 2.
Fly with Caution
racing up strongly. Hauling in Boab Boy. Good run. He got across, found the front, but just couldn't see it out. Finishing second to Fly with Caution. And third, Fast Flicker making ground from a long way back on the corner. And Here for Checks, boxing on well, as held fourth over the filly. Princess in Red, fifth and sixth, Ocean Zara. Interim numbers, 10, 3, 4 and 2. 10 the winner, Fly with Caution. Back-to-back wins for the Gilding of Three by Galar out of Be So Royal, or Be So Risky at least, and Fly with Caution winning both his last two for owners C and Mrs. D. Witten. Michael Poy for trainer Robert Witten. It's won by 2 1/4, short head, second to third. 123.87 the time, 123.87, 2 1/4 and a short head. Well, our boy just couldn't quite see it out after getting across and finding the front. Just put a little gap, two or three lengths in the middle stages. Lucy Fiori for trainer Brett Pope. Gelding by Sessions out of Therese. And in third spot was number four, Fast Flicker, from the back of the field. Steve Parnham riding for Tony Triscari. And Here for Checks, Pat Carberry for Bernie Miller in fourth. So Fly with Caution will pay around about $3.80 and $1.80. Started tote favourite and around $4 on the WOP.
Fly with Caution.
Boab Boy at $4.70 and
Fly
Fast Flicker at $1.80. Winner returning. Third leg of the quaddy going to Fly with Caution. Back-to-back wins for Robert Witten. Michael Poy on board. We'll join Lockie Taylor now, who's down in the mounting yard.
Thanks, Matty. I'm now joined by winning trainer Robert Witten. Rob, Fly with Caution, you were oozing with confidence heading into his last start victory, and even post-race you mentioned the fact that this might be one of the nicest horses you've ever had. He looks like he's come on since then.
He's improved out of sight. His work last Saturday was just exceptional. I'd really take no credit for it. Kate's done all the work and she makes me a good trainer, I'll tell you.
From that low draw, he had a lovely run in behind the speed. He looks awfully versatile at this early stage of his career. He can settle handy, absorb pressure, and then he has a turn of foot to match that as well.
Yeah, he's certainly got a turn of foot, and I still think the Derby riding back, he'd be a better horse. We went to the races with a fair bit of confidence, but when Michael come out and said, doesn't matter where we'll sit, we'll just blow this lot away, you sort of gives you even more confidence. But no, he's a really nice horse. Yeah, just good fun. Bought his mother. I bought his grandmother, bred his mother, bred this bloke. His family owned horse, Really good.
That was his second win at 1,400 metres. What do you do with him now? The way he found the line, it wouldn't look like a mile would trouble him.
I won't worry him at all. We've been waiting to try and get him in a mile. We'll have a look. We'll just see how he pulls up. I don't know. We just don't make decisions on race day, but geez, he bounces out of his races and his work better than I do, I can tell you.
And I get the feel from you and the team that it's a great sense of satisfaction as well from a different side of the fence, in the sense that there are a lot of great people and a lot of close people to your family in this horse.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Kate has ambitions to train horses, and to be quite honest, she's doing all the work. You've got to have a flagship horse, and this is going to be the horse that's going to help her. And eventually, when she sort of finishes riding, and she's on compo due to a head injury, unfortunately, at the moment, eventually she will train in partnership, you know, which would be a great thrill. It's just a really nice horse, just good fun.
Congratulations, Rob. A great thrill for you and the family. Well done.
Thanks very much.
There's Robert Whitten after the win of Fly With Caution, and here's Michael Poy catching up with Scotty.
Who's building a really good association with this horse, Michael. Very similar run in transit to last start, an even more impressive result.
He was. Not easy to do it two times in a row, but I've been working this horse in between runs, and the horse hasn't taken a backward step. It's, if not improved. I thought it was a stay out of trouble and get it to fresh air first up job. Today, I thought we could probably run into trouble and it would still be too good for the job. Credit to Kate, she hasn't put a foot wrong with this horse. She's done everything over it, hasn't left one stone unturned. Robert runs the farm down in Bunbury and Kate does an amazing job with them up here. Like, not many of them run a bad race, and when they think they can really win, they really put them away. They don't muck around, they don't just win, they win with a bit of authority.
Been running the drone footage today in the early stages, and watching you out of the barriers, it seemed as though Jason Whiting was on your outside, but unfortunately for him, there's no way you're going back to the fence.
No, I was lucky enough. I was able to keep one just to me inside, and I kind of held Jason off for enough where I could follow that horse up and get to the outside of its heels, so I had that spot one off the rail. If the horse towards the rail slid up, I would have had to have gone back there, but I think the way it won, it wouldn't really have mattered. It was get out with 100 to go, probably still run over them.
What would the feedback be? Would stay at 1,400 metres, go to a mile? What would your expectation of distance be?
I don't think it really matters, 14 a mile. I think that's really going to suit Ascot because it's quick runs to those first two turns, even the mile and the 14, and the horse does get a bit keen. But with those quick runs, usually there's good speed. We've been lucky, we've drawn soft both times. Probably if you draw bad, you'd rather go to the mile to make up the ground.
Great insight, thanks.
Thank you.
There's Michael Poy combining with Robert Whitten and Fly With Caution to take out the Strange Love Handicap.
Let's go and see.